Ever wondered how to skewer someone with a what looks like a shark spear in a boat in the sea? Well, no, neither have I. But Perfect Alibi, the game where you can get away with murder if you've got the perfect alibi, is here for us to find out just how. Join us as we play and review. Voila, we've got it. Right, so, to the box. It's pretty box standard, to be fair. It's quite flimsy. It's, basic cardboard. You've got the age denotation, 10 plus, 3 to 5 players, 30 to 45 minutes. Rulebook, let's have a quick flick through. So you've got it in English, you've got it in German, or English and, let's say English and American, but English pretty much is it. You've got French, you've got German, you've got English, and then I think you should have you should have Scandinavian, that's Norwegian. I think that there's Scandi, or is that it? I think that's it, no, because I guess, yeah, that's your lot. Interesting. Okay, fair enough. So then we've got our scorecards. Not bad, not very weighted paper, but there you go. You've got your sort of suspects, etc. Cards and your punch out stuff, pretty good. I like the fact that the cards are punch out, that's good. And then you've got your perfect alibi board. And then you should have your perfect alibi cards, your actual suspect cards. Well, it all looks pretty much in order. So then join us as we play and then review Perfect Alibi. So come on in, come on in, come on in. It's like fire when you see my chrome spin. Right, hi everyone, and welcome to this game club playthrough. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to quickly play through Perfect Alibi with a five player game. I'm just going to put my five tokens out. One, two, three, four, and five. So this would be if there's five players or effectively five teams. We won't be playing the expansion. There is a variant of it. The variant, which we won't be playing. Now that variant is called the rival variant, and that is basically where you have particular rivals which will cause or allow you to do things. In particular, you'll be able to fib to them about cards that you hold. But effectively what happens is we will play as five players, and these are all the cards in the game, and basically that are all the pack that's there. So these are all the suspects and locations, etc, etc. I'll just shuffle these up and I'll deal them out to each player. So I've got three each. So one, so two. There you go. Apologies, I'm trying to look at the camera while doing this, so it's slightly tricky. Two, three. And I'll leave one over, which will slot in here. And this is basically how the game will look. Now, obviously each player will get one of these, and generally the way I distribute it, although the booklet, the rule booklet, which we will be following mostly here, and just to note, there is a very good walkthrough of this, which is a kind of point-by-point one by the guy from the Dice Tower, Dice Cube, very good as well. I'll just put 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and each of those have particular variants, particular attributes which they offer to each player, and allow you to do certain things, which is always very useful. Now, the reason I'm basically going to run through this is just to show you kind of what the game is about. What effectively will happen is each player will get one of these no papers, and I agree that there's not enough of these, so I would suggest if you buy this, instantly go ahead and photocopy probably 20 of these, because if you're playing it with more than three people, you'll find you'll fly through it, because you'll play it at least four or five times. It's quite a robust and addictive sort of game like that. What you'll do is you'll mark off the particular cards that you've got here in order for you then to know what questions you're going to ask. And as you can see, you have time, location, and the person themselves there as well. So what happens then is you've got your stack of tokens or coins, and they have particular symbols on them, which I'll explain in just a second. But you will go and put four down here, and you'll turn away. So I go one, keep that one, two, three, almost mix, four, very good, nice little mix there. So, and effectively what happens now is you, the first player here is blue, will be able to ask you a question. Now, what I would recommend is, when you're first playing it, you keep hold of this, because you will notice that on the particular tiles, there is a requirement to understand what each one does. And so as you can see here, each one will allow you to say ships will allow you to ask about location, the time, so the ships will ask about location, the time will be able to you to ask about time, so you can ask other players. What effectively you do is you choose this and you'll be able to ask this player about time, choose these and you'll be able to ask these players about location. And then of course you've got the changing assistant. If you choose the interrogation chip shown with two arrows, the asking player must exchange his assistant tile before a question is asked. So effectively you have to exchange this with another player. He then takes either another unused assistant from the box next game or the assistant of the player being interrogated. So effectively he would have to take the green assistant there, but obviously that works more appropriately when obviously you're playing it with less players. But what happens is once you've chosen one of these, you then replace it with another one from there as well. But that's how it works. You've got location and you've got clock here, which is for time. Now, to note, the other thing to remember is that if you ask for, say for instance, this guy here asks it for this here, he may ask anyone because it's his colour, so he can basically ask anyone there. And once again, I would recommend keeping your booklet close by, because it will just allow you to understand and explore how that works, because it can be, the first few times it can be quite confusing. You only get one of these plates as well, which is slightly annoying, because when you're ticking off all of these, and as you can see what they've got here is they've got, so you can cut this off so you can have these sort of sections. I actually prefer to have this in front of me and be able to mark it off, because obviously it matches to here, but also allows you that flexibility of being able to, like, and I have to mention that the dreaded accursed, or one of the people complain about Cluedo, it allows you to be able to go, okay, I'm defining that it's going to be A, B, C, D, Mr. Cuddle Mustard in the diary room with whatever. So there you go. Now, that all said, what will happen at the end is you will then get down to where you've made an assumption, you can do the guess, and you will effectively take off this card and go, there we go, and you'll find out who the murderer is. This season we've already seen Awkward Guests surface, and that was a great game with a lot of differing and varying possibilities. Perfect Alibi actually is far more restricted in that sense, but it plays actually far more easier because of the fact that one, you don't have to rely on an app or rely on a bunch of cards. Instead, what you rely on is intuition, and I actually quite like that, because it doesn't force the player into having to go round after round building very gradually the picture, which actually I enjoy. But to be fair, what I do also enjoy is if I'm playing with other people who are not so big on that, then a game like this is akin to, and I'd say it because it is the game which really is the foundation of it, Cluedo. In fact, I'd actually say it's akin to reading a Christie novel, to be fair, because it is basically, you would have effectively 12 chapters, and there's around about 10 rounds in this which you'll play, or even, to be fair, 6 rounds, but I say 10 because obviously every player will play, so it will feel slightly longer, and you can always ascertain information from other players by nudges, movements, etc. The strengths of Perfect Alibi is the fact that it doesn't allow for the game to roll on and doesn't allow for there to be a moment when you're effectively running after your tail because you've got so many red herrings. This game is far less about red herrings, it's far more about clear deduction. And I think that's a boon, because it's the sort of game that you can play a couple of times in a row and you wouldn't find it to be too straining, but it also would be the fact that it would still receive something, you could still get a prize out of it. My biggest problems is that, one, the pad itself, there's not enough on there, you have to photocopy it, you'll run through it very quickly. Two, the variant option adds a layer to it, but to be fair, I would probably avoid that until you've mastered this game, and that can take a couple of plays, maybe sort of 3 or 4 weeks worth of playing before you really get to grips with it. Because I think some of it can be, even though it looks simple, some of it can be slightly difficult, because it's about gauging questions and gauging responses. It also is, when you get your cards, your assistant cards, you need to just sort of flesh out what they do and also whether they're beneficial or not. And then finally, the other thing is that one single card that you get, they should have given everyone a card and had one in the middle, or even got disposed of that, because I don't see the real point of having in the middle, because what is it really serving the purpose? Is it so everyone can look at but not be able to tick off? So that all said, Perfect Alibi is a sort of game, if you like Cluedo, if you're a fan of deduction games but don't want to have a deduction game that is a kind of Sherlock Holmes-esque massive mammoth task, then this is probably for you. Playable, it does say 10 up, I would agree with that. It says 3 to 5 players, best in my personal opinion is 4, 5 is too much, 3 is not enough, and then 30 to 45 minutes. It doesn't cross full 30 minutes, to be fair. I don't even think you'll max out 40 minutes. 30 minutes we found, we've played it 4 times now. 30 minutes is pretty much it. That's with 4 people, and with 3 people it was even quicker than that. So that was Perfect Alibi. I'm Simon, and this is Game On. Thank you for watching.